Hi everyone, Christina here. Welcome to another video at my YouTube channel and blog. Today's video is going to be a little bit different. I want to talk to you guys about traveling with watercolors or some different ideas on what you can do if you want to be watercolor painting on the go. So I'm going to walk you through a few of my more travel-sized watercolor palettes, and I'm going to talk about one that's new to me that I haven't opened yet that I thought I'd kind of like test and walk through with you guys. The first one I want to talk about is one that you guys have seen me use in the past quite a bit, and it is this Pocket Field Sketchbox from Sakura Koi, and I've used this palette a ton over the years. It's really great. One of the things that I really like about this palette is that it has this extra little insert for it that extends the palette and has a spot here where you put the legs in, and then you can hold the palette in your hand while you're working and use a water brush and pick up your paint and use this surface up here for mixing, as well as these different divided wells down here. So it's really convenient in that way. Also, if you don't want to worry about putting a wet palette away and having it spill or things being messy once you're inside, you could do what I usually do, which is I just put this palette up here at the top. I use that for all my painting, and then I move it down, and this leaves this lid up here completely free of any paint so that I can close it up, and I don't have to worry about any of those wet spot splotches coming down and getting onto the inside of my watercolor palette box. So these paints are actually really, really fantastic. A lot of people who start out with some cheaper paints that might not be quite as creamy, and then they try this set, they tell me it's night and day. They love it. The colors are very pigmented. They're easy to work with, and you have a wide range of colors to choose from. I really like this palette, and it's also fairly inexpensive. You can definitely get it for under $30, sometimes even under $20, depending on where you buy it from. So it's a fantastic palette. You can get it at Simus Stamp or Amazon. I will have links to this palette and everything else I'm talking about today in the video description, or you know, at my blog. So I'm going to go ahead and close this up. Oh, I did want to mention that it does come with a water brush, which is actually a really good water brush. Let me see if I can grab mine. I think I have it in here. Yeah, this is the water brush that it comes with. And when it's all when it's put together, it won't fit inside. But they actually, when it comes to you, to get this unscrewed, actually, I don't know if I can, it's been a long time. you can take this section off and then you can slide it in here and have the brush in the same palette box. So it's actually really convenient. I took mine out and I always use it with a regular watercolor brush or with a water brush. I don't store it in this because I'm usually taking some other brushes with me, so I just keep all the brushes together. But if you wanted to be really minimalist and only use the brush that comes with the palette, you definitely could do that. I'll close that up. Okay, now I'm going to talk about this one. And this is actually one of the palettes from Prima. But I love that the palettes are small and that you get a variety of colors. This is the Decadent Pies color collection box or whatever. For how compact this palette is, you actually get a lot of mixing space, and this is a standard size half pan. So if you wanted to, you could buy this set and mix and match different paints to whatever ones you want. So if you have another set of watercolor paints that has half pans, you could swap the colors in and out. I know a lot of people, if you go to buy a pan palette like this, separate from any colors, they can be quite expensive, and they would sometimes be the same price or higher than if you just bought the Prima set and swapped out the Prima watercolors for ones that you like more. So you can either use the Prima colors or some that you've chosen on your own. You can mix and match and make your own perfect palette for whatever you're working on. So if you wanted to, you could find some smaller compact brushes and store that inside right there as well. I'm going to go ahead and put this back together. I like to put this swatch on the first fold and then close that up. So this is from Prima. Like I said before, this is sort of a very common style for metal watercolor palette boxes. So you could definitely find some other tins that are similar. I just like the premium one because the price is really affordable. Okay, so this is another travel palette I like. This is basically just a very inexpensive palette, plastic palette, that I bought on Amazon. You can find these at art stores and all over the place. I believe this one was, you know, a couple dollars. And I took my tube watercolors that I really love and filled it with the colors that I use the most often. These are all colors from Winsor & Newton. This is a fairly small palette, so I use it for both travel and then also when I'm just working on smaller projects like cards or smaller little posters or inspirations, things like that. Anything that's smaller, because I have a big palette that is quite large and it takes up a large area of like surface area on my desk. And this palette is a lot smaller and it also folds down very compact. It's very skinny. I took a Sharpie marker and just wrote the colors on the outside so that I know what the colors are and I can refill them later. If you need to take one of these off, you can use an alcohol wipe or alcohol, rubbing alcohol, and it just takes that Sharpie right off the surface of the plastic. So this is another way I like to travel with watercolors. I've actually traveled with this particular palette multiple times to different crafting retreats and it's held up really, really well. I enjoy it. And if you want to customize your palette completely with all colors that you choose yourself, this is a great way to do it. Another really great option for travel watercoloring is to use watercolor markers. These are Zig Clean Color Real Brush markers. They're really ones that I like to use traveling a ton because they're so convenient. They're not as messy as what like normal watercolors would be, especially if you are only working on your lap. You don't have a hard surface in front of you like a table or a desk. So these are really fantastic. I usually travel with a water brush. I usually travel with a water brush of some sort when I'm using the Zig Clean Color Real Brush markers, but you could definitely use just a regular watercolor brush. And speaking of, if you're using your regular watercolor brush, you'll want to have some sort of water container. Sometimes I just use a little plastic cup from the hotel bathroom, or actually Faber-Castell sells a collapsible, like I think it's silicone even, cup that you can travel with you, you know, so you don't ever have to use a drinking cup. You can use the specific for crafting cup to do all of your painting. So you can definitely do that as well. Another travel watercolor medium that I really love to use, especially with the water brush, is Peerless watercolors. Now, I wanted to briefly touch on this and my palette. When you buy the Peerless watercolors, they come in sets like this, where it's a full sheet of the color, or in this case, they're the half sheets. You'll notice that I've cut out some squares out of this one. I've cut out a square out of all of them because I created my own Peerless watercolor palette. I based mine off of a palette made by Julie Ebersol for Ellen Hudson, and I will link up to her video up here in the top corner where you can make your own Peerless watercolor palette like this. But I find this is super, super, super convenient, especially if I'm doing lettering or really simple watercoloring. I wouldn't want to do any big washes of color with these little swatches because I find that I don't get quite enough volume of paint to work like that. But for smaller projects or doing just a little bit of color across the page, I think it works fantastic. And you can't, the value in these can't be beat. They last forever and ever and ever. I've had this palette, I think like 2 years or so. And these are the colors I use most often. So I actually have taken out the big pieces of them and put them in here because I use them so often. But other than that, I haven't had to replace any of these colors. They're fantastic. I have both the bonus pack as well as the main pack, the main colors, the complete edition in this palette. So, and there's plenty of room to spare. If I ever want to pick up some additional colors, I can put them in. I made mine have lots and lots of space. So that's Peerless watercolors. I'll put in some images of some things that I've done with Peerless watercolors while I'm traveling. So these are some pure examples of things I've created traveling with the Peerless watercolor palette and a watercolor brush. Okay, so before I move on to this other watercolor travel option that I haven't tried before, but I'll show you today, I want to talk about watercolor paper and what you might take while you're traveling. So this is a little 4x6 block of watercolor paper from Canson. This is a great watercolor paper to work with, and it's also fantastic for travel. The one thing you want to remember is that if you're going to be painting more than just that first sheet that's on the top, you're going to need something to take the sheets off the block. So you're going to need some scissors or a bone folder or even just a ruler, something to get under the edge of that watercolor paper and then break the gumming around the edge so you can get that first sheet of watercolor paper off the block. So this is a really fantastic option. I also have a couple notebooks that are the same watercolor paper from Canson, and those are actually the ones that I travel with. I don't have one out with me right now, but I'll see if I can find some pictures of it and put them on screen right now. It's a great notebook. It's spiral bound. I believe Simon's a Stamp carries a spiral bound notebook with the same watercolor paper, and it has it doesn't have like the hard covers on it. So it's a really economical option if you want to try that watercolor paper for travel or even just at home. I also wanted to show that the last time I was traveling, I went to a family reunion. I brought this watercolor coloring book from Christy Rice. This is the Painterly Days flower watercoloring book. And it has these fantastic sheets that you can remove. And I actually just put this right on top of the book and use this book. It's pretty sturdy. I use that for all of my painting. I was using some Zig markers for this and it was fantastic. So if you want to do a little bit of travel painting, take a watercolor coloring book with you. It's fantastic. Okay, so now I'm going to go over that new palette or the new paints that I have not used yet. This is from Kuretake. I got it from Jet Pens, and you probably can't see that on screen, but I'm going to read some info from the website. 12 different Japanese watercolors, and it comes with a water brush. And let's see here. Includes one watercolor palette, a portable water bottle, so that's good for filling your brush, a compact water brush, and a carrying case. And it says that these are Kuretake Gonzite watercolor palette. So I'm assuming, since it's from the same brand, these are going to be very similar to that large Gonzite Tombi palette that the crafting world has fully embraced and absolutely loves. So if these are the same colors, I think that's fantastic because we're going to be very used to working with them. Okay, so I'm looking at the back of this and it looks like it's showing how to set the book up. We'll see. Oh, this is nice. Has a whole little travel thing. Okay. Looks like some watercolor paper that comes in it, just a couple sheets. And then here is the palette. And that illustration, I think it's telling me to put it in like this. I assume this is how you would put it in. So the band goes over the hinge on that. You have your mixing palette over here. You can store your water brush and the water in that area. And then you also have a couple other little pockets over here to store some other things. I think they're telling me to do the watercolor paper right here. So you have it all very compact. It closes up. And then also it has a band on the back. So it's showing me to put my hand through that. And then I can use it. I can hold it with one hand while I paint. That's kind of a cool idea. I like that. Okay, so it's very compact. I'm not entirely sure how to take. Oh, there we go. Okay. And then you just slide that inside. It's a little itty bitty brush. That's awesome. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and fill this brush with water and see what happens. Now, this container is nice, and it's plastic, and you can squeeze it. That's really nice, because what I've been using for travel is this eyedropper bottle, and it's glass, and I haven't had any problems with it, but like I said, it's glass. So that would actually be really convenient. Since I have my glass one filled up with water, I'm going to go ahead and use it to fill the water brush. I have a little square of watercolor paper, so I'm going to come over here and get a little water out on the palette. A couple little droplets in the colors, and just see how they'd work. I think you would still want some paper towels to clean off your brush, so you could put that in this pocket right here. The colors look really nice. That red is very pigmented. I'm guessing they're probably, it's probably the same paint as what's in their larger palette, but I can't say for sure because I'd have to compare them side by side. Well, let's just go ahead and do that now. All right, I have my big palette here. This looks to be about this color, or maybe this one. I'm not entirely sure. I think it might be this one. So I'll just grab some color over here. Oh yeah, it's exactly the same paint. It's going on with the same intensity. And then looks like this color right here is probably this one right here. I'm not sure for sure, but it looks like it probably is. I have no idea. Nope, different color. But you guys get the idea. I think it's the exact same paints, but in a very, very small palette. And they give you a pretty good range of colors. I think this is a purple down here. That's a nice violet, purple, and gray. I'm not sure what this one is. Black. And up there is a dark blue. Perfect. So I think this is actually a pretty good set. Let's see, if I was going to close up after a bunch of painting, I might find it a little bit tricky to get this palette out without spilling, but I do like that it closes up. There's quite a bit of water still floating around in there, so I would be concerned about, see, it's the blue is transferring to the top of the palette. So this isn't one of those travel palettes that you would want to wait until everything's dry before you close up shop, but not too bad. I will close up my water brush. And once again, just going to pull this out and put it down into, I'm not sure how secure that is. I don't know if water would leak. I'm going to squeeze that and see if water is going to leak out. Looks pretty good. No water leaking. Put that together and then close this up. So that's actually a pretty good little palette with the case, and there's space to put some other things in there. So that's actually kind of nice. Now let's talk brushes. When I travel with watercolors, I generally will only take a water brush because it's so convenient to do so. And like I mentioned with that other palette, I like to travel with a little bit of extra water. You can use a small water bottle. And then you get a little eyedropper to refill it. This one happens to be glass. I've traveled with it and I haven't had a problem. However, it is glass. So that plastic one in that Kuretake palette might be a really great option, and I might have to switch to that for traveling. As far as regular brushes go, I found this container at my local Dick Blick store, and I think they might have it online. I'll look for it online and link to it down below if I find it. But basically, this is a customizable brush container that you can change the height to be however tall you need it to be for whatever brushes you're using. So I bring it down to just right above the tallest brush, and then you can lock that in place. And then this lid goes on just like that. So this keeps my brushes really nice and safe. You can also use a brush roll or even just use a kitchen towel or maybe a stack of paper towels and just roll your brushes up in that. Using a towel is a great idea because you'll be needing some sort of towel or paper towel to help clean off your brush as you're painting. So having it wrapped up in that is also a really great idea. Okay, so these are my recommendations on traveling with watercolors. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you're like me and you want to take your crafting or art on the road with you when you're traveling, these are some great options to keep you painting even when you're away from home. Thanks for watching today. I will catch you guys in a card video tomorrow.